not crack. Okay, now that I cracked my back and my other joints, I feel rain, right as rain to review this. Been up all night, so I look a little tired. That's why I look a little exhausted. So this is my review on SpongeBob the Musical live on stage. Now this doesn't have this is not the one of the original cast, because I didn't see the original cast from this musical. And this is a different, I don't know if this is the original cast or not, but I watched this on YouTube when it was still free. Now I have to pay for it, and I say it's worth the price. I say if you have to pay for it, and just you can't rent it, this you can only buy it. And I say buy it if you are a SpongeBob fan, or a fan of good quality storytelling, and a fan of plays and music, and not just music that sounds good, but music that has stories in it, and written well, and crafted well, and then yeah, go ahead and buy it on YouTube. Okay, so the whole, this is not a typical Bikini Bomb day, and Mr. Krabs is trying to give the business to Pearl and says SpongeBob, you know, he's the one that really deserves it, but he just sees SpongeBob as this is simple sponges and this a everyday loser, you know? And that's, it's really not fair because he's been, and in this timeline, he's been the Pokemon's 2 months in a 2 years in a row, actually. So I think he deserved that promotion, Mr. Krabs. Since you asshole, I think. And everything's, a size of, like, SpongeBob Night King promotion, the promotion. Breaking news, it's gonna be the end of the world by tomorrow. And this volcano's going to erupt and destroy the King and bomb everyone along with it. But don't worry, it's still comedy. They don't lose their sense of humor. They're still aware that you want to laugh in a SpongeBob play. So even though it tackles the underworld topic, it still feels like its own identity because it feels like classic SpongeBob. You know how they handle the whole topic and stuff. It's not too depressing. The play is rated. The play's rated G, so well, it says TVG. I guess this was on TV, so and it's pretty engaging, and it can be sad and hot one and funny at times. So that's because all these emotions mixed into that you'll be experiencing in the play, and you really feel bad for SpongeBob because He does his musical number. It's funny how he always, his dream is to be the boss of the Krusty Krab and own it. But Krabs doesn't see that much in SpongeBob, so it's going to go to Pearl. So, and and this is when people won't listen to Stanley's science prediction after she explains, does a whole math thing that they only have till tomorrow to live. Then Plankton comes and she tries to come up with a plan quick enough, then Plankton comes up with a different plan, saying when the going gets tough, the tough gets lost. And this is one of his schemes to get people to eat at the chum bucket, and he will basically trap, his plan is to trap everyone in a rocket, to trap them all, and go to this new planet he's going to call it Chumville. And Krab is in sees right through his sounds, has a feeling that breaks, interrupts his thing. It sounds like one of his schemes. So to win everyone over, he does a hip hop song. That is when pretty much everyone over except for SpongeBob, Patrick, and Sandy, which are three main heroes of the film, because they're going to do what they can to save the King Bottom and try to stop the volcano from erupting and killing everyone. Yeah. So, SpongeBob goes to Sandy because they need her for his brains and that can be the bronze. And, Sandy's about to lead the King Bottom because the people can be about to accept SpongeBob and Patrick have turn her and blame her for everything that's wrong and the world ending and stuff. And then Patrick leaves the group after becoming king of this cult because he thinks he's a genius. And they're looking for someone to turn to, so Patrick doesn't end up helping SpongeBob and Sandy. Then he comes back because he misses his best friend. And the world's about to end, this takes place in 2 days, and this is day two of when world's about to end, the King Bottom's world's about to end, so, and destroy the King Bottom, and everyone living in it, Sandy comes with this brilliant idea to use this bubble to put pressure on volcano. Hopefully that will stop volcano from erupting. But it's a bit of a slim chance, I think she said. She says it's a slim chance. But so the all three of them sound like it's a good idea. And so they go roll with it, and then Patrick comes back. And leaves the cult and leaves being the guru of the cult and to help his real friends Sandy and SpongeBob helping them save the world. And Patrick somehow gets a hold of the jetpack and saves SpongeBob from falling to his doom. Well, they climb the volcano and at some point they try getting Squidward on the team, but he turns it down easily, and Squidward gets flushed, although he apparently has a bit of a whenever he fires the band that was supposed to raise money to save the King Bomb, because they think he's a loser, so he calls them a loser, and yeah, they quit, anyway, the plan isn't already effective, but everyone and the King Bottom is turning on each other, and it's basically out of control, and the plan is already in progress, because they put the bubble in the volcano. And hopefully that will work and stop the volcano from erupting because of the pressure. So, yeah. So, I gotta pull my pants up because it's falling down because I'm losing weight. So, SpongeBob puts a stop to the madness and points out that everything that they're doing is wrong. And even if, and it doesn't matter if the world's ending or not, saying that they shouldn't do this and they shouldn't turn on each other, they shouldn't look for someone to turn to for help and create a cult or anything. And he yells at Squidward after Squidward interrupts SpongeBob, and he says, just yells to Squidward, "I'm not finished." He basically says, "Look, no matter what happens, if you keep on behaving this way, there won't be a King Ball to save, because the King Ball is where the people are, civilians, where the people are." So he tells, I guess, everyone to pull their heads together and tells them to make the best out of what's left of the day, even if the world ends. To make that saying that could still be the best day ever, even if they die. Because that's what he believes, that he can make the all together. If they get one, pull their heads together, they can make the day still the best day ever, even if the world ends. And they all die. So he starts singing, he changed the lyrics to fit the story while sings the best day ever song. And then everyone starts to join in, including Squilly, which was, that was a big surprise. And they all hold hands together once they finish the song, saying there's only one. When there's only 1 minute left, they all hold each other's hands and pray for the best, even though the worst is likely to come. And the plan works. The volcanoes erupt because of Sandy's brilliant strategy of stopping the volcano, and a plan was helped with SpongeBob and Patrick. And SpongeBob now says that Mr. Krabs says SpongeBob that he was wrong, that he's not just a stone sponge, and that he can have the Krusty Krab if he saying that he saying that I think offers him the offer to have the Krusty Krab. And so he's just so excited that Mr. Krabs says he can have the Krusty Krab, and respect that Pearl wants to do her own thing with her life and not own going to business, family business. So, and then plane comes clean that he was trying to scam everyone. It was one of his schemes. So, and that's the whole end, and it ends with them singing one last song. And I have to tie my pants right now, so I'm not going to shut the video off right now. That's why you're not seeing what you're hearing me, okay? My pants are very loose. They've gone loose since I last week. So I'm finished tying my pants, and they're not going to fall off now. So I'm giving this play a 10 out of 10. It's one of my favorite plays, and it's what I imagine a SpongeBob play would be like, actually. It's just that awesome.